Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another GI Watch Along. I am joined today by Dan Tack. Hello, sir.
Hey, what's up?
The jacket list I can see today.
Yeah, do you want me to go get one?
No, you live your best life, my friend. You're looking good today. The beard's looking good. You're looking svelte. I'm liking it. This is a good Dan Tack day.
Cool. You want to see svelte? You know what, Alex? I can, you want to see something, Alex?
Sure, yeah. Let's see what you got. Let's see what
you want to see something that you haven't seen before?
I do, actually. Is this going to be like a chat That's world premiere here? He's your father.
Now we need to okay. No one is ready for this.
No one is ready. No one in chat. Let's see. Whoa! Dan Tack, looking clean. I like it. Wouldn't you do that?
You know, sometimes we just like to get a little wild around here.
It looks good, man.
All right.
How you feel about it? Look at the chat. Talk this man up. He's styling today.
We like to get a little wild. We like to hang out. We like to Resident Evil. You know, clean heads and Resident Evil.
It's a perfect day. Yeah. Guys, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. Today, I am joined with Dan Tack to present to you the Resident Evil Showcase for April. If you haven't been over to the site, we have a lot of Resident Evil content up these days because it is our cover for this issue of the magazine. And as a part of that, myself and the lovely people at Game Informer, we've been working our butts off to give you some really awesome Resident Evil content, and that continues today with the Watch Along. Capcom is set to premiere what they've said is some more gameplay, and what I would imagine is show off some more of, you know, what's coming for the 25th anniversary and that kind of stuff. So, you know, exciting times if you're a Resident Evil fan. And chat, I hope you're doing well. Hope you're excited. Hope you're feeling the love, the energy. Like, this is going to be...
Okay. These are the two Halloween Town Keyblades. One of them's from the first game. One of them's from the second game.
Yes!
All right. Get hype. RE Village.
Oh, my God. You're a legend for a reason, man. Oh, my goodness. That's incredible. I'm so happy someone else likes Kingdom Hearts.
Okay?
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh yeah, I'm big. I'm sold. Okay, Kingdom Hearts sold me super hard. I'm glad I waited to play it though. Honestly.
Yeah.
Like the remix version or whatever. I know people don't want to talk about Kingdom Hearts today. It's Resident Evil Day, so let's talk about Resident Evil.
I was gonna say, what are you, Tack? You've been following the series very closely. Like, what are you excited for today? What do you want to see?
Well, if I was the internet, the only thing I would care about is more Lady Vampire. That's all. I can't read anything about this game anywhere. I don't know why. I don't know if this is like brilliant inadvertent marketing on Capcom's part. They're just like, yeah, everyone's gonna love the vampire lady. Let's just put her front and center.
Yeah.
Like, does anybody even care about anything else at this point? I wish they did. You know, that's all I see. You know, that's the perception, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I'd like to see some more game systems, you know? I know Game Informer's got the scoop on those.
Yeah, we do, baby. Yeah.
But that's the kind of stuff that I want to see, you know? I played the demo. Mm-hmm. I was intrigued. But yeah. The demo was really like a slice, right? Like,
it was so short. It
how
was
does
real
that
quick.
Tie into the actual game?
Yeah.
Are we going to get to see more of the actual game today? Prediction, yes.
That's a damn prediction right there, baby.
I like to make some really bold predictions in my life, all right? That's yes, maybe the most bold I've ever said.
Yes, you do. Yeah, I'm excited to see. As Dan alluded to, we have our first video of our cover month. Or cover a couple of weeks up, and that is detailing the upgrade system, which, you know, hasn't been necessarily like the first priority for these games, but it seems like it's going back to maybe a little bit more RE4 themed in a lot of ways for the upgrades. And we showed off the hunting and the cooking, so if you're curious about that, definitely go check it out on the YouTube page. But I think we're at the point now where it's like I'm with you. I want to see more systems. I want to see how this thing is going to play because, guys, we are less than a month away from this game. May 7th is the day that this game comes out.
I am curious about the hunting and the cooking. If there's one thing I've always wanted to do in a Resident Evil game, it's hunt and cook, right? Wait a minute.
Wait.
What are we doing in this game? What's happening here?
Exactly. Are we gonna
hunt and cook down zombie dogs? That doesn't sound very sanitary.
Oof, no, I would like to avoid that if necessary.
All I know is today, you know, like you said, we are close to this game. Can someone please? So it's time to show the goods, right? It's time to let us know what else this game has to offer other than Lady Vampire, which, okay, is really cool,
it's
right?
Great, but yeah. Like, what else do we got?
Is that all they have to do? I think they stumbled into this one, but basically all they do is put like Lady Vampire. Put it out on Twitter, and then the internet just starts, you know,
goes
turning into
blaze.
A churning sea of like piranhas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dan, are you? Describe to me your Resident Evil fandom, because I think there's multiple schools of thought here, right? There's a lot of people who love like those first couple of games, very, you know, claustrophobic, you know, isolated type of games, and then there's people who like RE4 and like some of the more action packed ones. Like, where do you fall on that?
So I'm an old school RE fan, so okay. I like 1, 2, 4, and I kind of fallen off on the series recently, you know, but I thought 2 remake was inspired. I really loved that.
Yeah,
that was great. So
let's see what
you know
remake.
And I'm more interested in the whole Capcom revival narrative across the board is really fascinating to me, RE included.
Yeah.
Like, you know, they have been on fire the last few years with Monster Hunter, RE, all these brands that frankly were left to languish a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And dude, I'm in. Let's see what happens. Like,
yeah.
So interestingly enough, yeah, I actually, Julian in chat I was just about to comment on that, dude. Like, everything I see from this game, like, I start looking through the Game Informer screenshots and exclusive stuff that we got, like the images and stuff. I'm like, wait a minute. That's just Bloodborne. Right? Like,
yeah.
There's a very heavy, like, I love that kind of stuff. It's not obvious. I'm not saying it's taking from Bloodborne, but it really taps into the werewolves, Victorian horror, big zombie dudes, big axes, big gray stones.
Yeah,
I love that look. You know, that's good stuff.
Yeah, yeah, I agree.
RPG, right? Whoa.
Yeah, that was close. That's okay though. I'm with you because I was talking about on the GI show this week, which you guys can go check out right now. We go more in depth on our digital cover trip we went on to go talk to the folks at Capcom. I'm weird in many ways, but I'm weird in my taste for like horror and my appetite for it, because like if it's separated just enough from like reality, so like aliens, vampires, like werewolves, I'm okay. Like, I can separate myself, you know. Like, I don't love like the body horror and the torturing and stuff like that stuff. I'm out, you know. So like this Resident Evil is intriguing to me because it's a theme that I can get behind a little bit more, and it seems like with the upgrade system, what they've shown so far, that whilst it is still very much a horror game, it seems like people who like action a little bit more can find a common ground in this. Whereas I feel like 7 was just like, look at us. We're going to scare the absolute crap out of you, and we don't care like how you feel about it. So
I got to play 7. Chat says I got to play 7. I think I got to play 7.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to play 7, gang.
Mm.
All right, it's on Game Pass. I might as well do it.
You might as well. You know, you got less than a month.
That's going to be tough to push it in less than a month. But I think I'll give it a try. I'll give it a try.
As Izzy says in chat, animals clap back. You better believe it, they do. Animals will fight back in this game if you try to take their meat. So
it's a bear. There's a bears in this, right?
Oh, I hope so. I don't know.
You don't want to F with a bear.
No.
You don't want to F with a wolf. You know, any of these things that you mess with in video games, man, like, in reality, you don't want to mess with any of this stuff, like, ever. Mm-hmm. You see one of these things, you run. You run fast.
Oh, yeah.
Downhill, and, you know, you go. You go.
Get out of
no
there.
It's no joke.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, chat, I'm curious what you guys are hoping to see today, you know, excited for, all the above. It's you know, if this is anything like the last show's case, it's not just going to be Village, right? We are hopefully gonna, like, because they talked about like the 25th anniversary, some of the collaborations that they're doing. You know, I'm curious to see, like, you know, is the Netflix thing gonna be a part of this? Like,
oh,
you know,
boy, Netflix.
I don't know.
Resident Evil 4 remake.
You ever heard of that? Oh,
I
yeah.
Have. We're not gonna see that today, I don't think.
No.
But you know, that's, you know, we don't know, but you know.
Correct. Like, it has to, yeah, I would imagine you're right, right? Like, that is such, I mean, that's a lot of people's, I know Blake Hester at GI, like, that's one of his favorite games of all time, and I think a lot of people fall into that as well. So, I can't imagine a world where we don't get that eventually, but I don't think we'd hear about
it. That's an old school Dan Predicts. I think that was like 2 or 3 years old. We had that as one of the original Dan Predicts.
OG okay? Dan Predicts. I love it.
Take that one out of the book.
Real Draft Punk says, give us Wesker. Wesker would be interesting.
Yo, what's up?
We haven't seen Wesker in a second.
Chat is ready for this.
Oh, yeah.
Chat, 3 minutes and some change left before the world changes forever. All right? Thanks for hanging with us for this. We do appreciate it.
We do.
I'll try to be quiet during the big reveals, but sometimes I got to be honest with you. I cannot help myself.
It happens.
The hype starts coming out of my orifices, all right?
He starts to glow powerful. Like Goku. He hits his final form and it's done. It's over. That's a good point to call out, though. We love everyone here, but just so you know, we are going to be talking. This is a watch along. We're watching with you guys. We're going to give you our thoughts. And we're gonna have some fun, you know. I'll make sure the audio is nice and crisp for you with 3 minutes to go here.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're gonna be talking. We're doing this with the GI community. Yeah.
We're gonna converse. So shout out to the first guy on YouTube who says, "Why don't these idiots shut up?" Over the I love that guy. I'm here for you, man. I'm giving you that content so you can lay that down on me. All right.
Because exactly.
I'm waiting for it.
Yep. Because you know what, you're giving us the view, and we appreciate that. So thank you. But yeah, I'm excited. I've gone from wanting to stay away from this series because I am a scaredy cat to being interested in this game. And
are you though?
Well,
I was there for you with Murder House, man. And I saw a man turn into steel during that playthrough.
Sometimes, or like when we did, not Devotion, but why am I blanking on this? What's the horror game you, Liana, and I played?
Visage? Did we play that?
No, not Visage. Why am I blanking on this? The horror game last year.
Phasmophobia.
Phasmophobia. I can turn it on when I need to, but I was a puddle after we turned the cameras off. I'll tell you what. Julian says you still got to play Visage, Alex. No, I do not. Thank you though.
You should though. Yeah. You should. It's really good.
You like it? Yeah.
Yeah, best horror game in the last decade, I think.
Ooh, wow. Okay.
I think. Yeah.
What do you think about the state of horror in games right now, Dan? Like, because we really, this Resident Evil feels like the only AAA horror game these days, right?
Horror is really tough for AAA, dude. Like, it's tough. You're in a genre that you lose a ton of the audience immediately just because, you know, you got the Alexes of the world who don't want to play a scary game.
Correct.
You know, you can't put that out there, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's tough. It's real tough.
Yeah.
Jake, I didn't say that. I mean, I you're right. I did not play RE7. So I'm talking about from my perspective, all right? I'm going to play RE7, all right? We're going to at least give it a try. All right. Okay. It's on the table, all right? I've said it. It's in the hopper.
Yeah. Jake says The Last of Us Part 2 is the best horror game in the last decade. I guess I don't consider Last of Us horror. I think it has scary elements, but I would say that's more of an action game, whereas this, you know, the Resident Evils and Evil Within's of the world are focused on actually scaring you with you know, with good horror trappings. Not that The Last of Us didn't have that, but, you know, if that's your horror game the last 10 years, God bless. So, 40 seconds. Chat, we are almost here.
Wait. One quick thing, Alex. How long is this little doohickey that we're going to be getting into right here?
I believe it's a half an hour. I think the last one was a half an hour. So we got some content coming your way.
I am so freaking hyped right now. I'm just going to start keyblading stuff, all right? Oh, my God. That's pumpkin. Let's get in there. Pumpkin werewolves. I'm ready. I'm ready. Let's go. Let's go.
It's turning up here. Let's see. All right, chat. We'll see you guys on the other side, and let's see what we got here. 7 seconds. Open the stream with that keyblade. Yeah. Get a little crossover going.
No. The place is full of nothing but blood and death.
Can someone please tell me what the hell is going on here?
Well, Ethan Winters.
Lady D.
What the hell was that?
Let's see what you're really made of. Ethan Winters.
Ethan Winters.
Really want you to know Ethan Winters is the main character.
I got it. I got the name now.
everyone, and welcome to the second Resident Evil Showcase. I'm your host, Brittany Brombacher, and I am so excited to be your guide through today's experience. We're going to hear from the Resident Evil team today, and they have so much new content for you. Another trailer, new gameplay, and more news for Resident Evil Village, which is right around the corner, coming to us on May 7th. We'll also be sharing the latest on the 25th anniversary of the series, and some fun surprises that go along with that, so stay tuned. To kick us off, I have the honor of introducing Jun Takeuchi, the executive producer of the franchise.
What do we got?
I love fun surprises. I heard there were going to be fun surprises.
Well, stay tuned. You're almost in luck.
Hi, I'm Jun Takeuchi, executive producer on Resident Evil. Due to your continued support, the franchise has reached its 25th anniversary. Thank you so much. 25 whole years, supported by so many of our fans. When I look back over the years and think about when we first started this project with Shinji Mikami, I never would have imagined that it would turn into such a long-lasting franchise. Even now, I want to see the series continue to succeed through your continued support. Now we've prepared the latest trailer for our upcoming title, Resident Evil Village.
It's okay.
It's weird. Yeah, it's same points, but I was just, it was throwing me off a little bit.
It has a huge breath of content, so brace yourselves.
All right, new trailer.
Well then, without further ado,
it said it has horror in it, so I'm really hyped for that. This is, I didn't expect that.
World premiere.
We need to get that voice, dude. Yeah. Where's he at?
I miss him.
As the midnight moon rises on black wings, we await the light at the end. In life and in death, glory to Mother Miranda.
Mother Miranda, what's she up to?
Hey, something's going on.
You're whining. We're almost there.
Rose, where are you?
Hello. If there are any survivors out there, come to my... to Louisa's house near the fields.
This May.
Oh, that's 6 months.
Yes, sir.
Whoa!
Oh, no. They're coming. Who is? What the hell was that?
Stop shouting. You'll draw the monsters.
Tell me what is going on around here.
It doesn't make any sense. Mother Miranda has always protected us.
You escaped my little brother's idiot games, did you? Let's see how special you are.
Oh, no. Mm.
All that's left from your entire village?
All that's left? There is no one left!
Oh god, we can bust out with this.
Lycans and gentlemen, we thank you for waiting. And now let the games begin!
Interesting. Okay.
There is no safe! Every sorry bastard out there has been ripped in half!
Tomorrow we're all be dead.
No, let me go!
Oh.
Chris, what the hell?
I saw a sea creature.
Yep.
Ethan Winters.
Ethan Winters, Mr. Winters.
Ethan Winters.
Ethan Winters.
Ethan.
Ethan Winters. Welcome.
All right. I think I figured it out. This game has a character named Ethan Winters.
I gotta say, I'm surprised you made it this far. It'd be a shame if something happened to you now.
You killed Mia. Now do me and finish the job.
Okay, what is happening with Chris? This is not, he's not a nice guy.
I am so hyped. I have no idea what just happened there, but I saw a sea creature, so I'm in.
What was that noise?
That was the hype train.
That was the hype train?
That's
okay.
So the hype train comes into the station.
I know we cannot wait to find out what Chris's involvement is. Now, in the last showcase, we promised that another demo was coming this spring. Something tells me it won't involve casual tea time with Lady Dimitrescu, but I don't think the internet would mind that.
I didn't know it was Dimitrescu.
I didn't pronounce that.
I thought it was Lady. I just said Lady
Dimitrescu.
Yeah.
Kanda-san, thank you so much for joining us again today.
Lady Dimitris. Okay, that's easier than I thought it was going to be.
Are you going to be able to take on Lady Dimitris if you have to in the game? Are you going to be able
Thank
to kill her?
Thank you for the introduction.
I feel like I would want her to like kill me a couple times just to see what it's like.
I'm Filthy Kanda, producer on Resident Evil Village.
And then I'd probably
Resident
take her
Resident Evil
out.
Village has been created with the concept of
She has to turn into a crazy tentacle monster at some point, right? Like, that's going to be the thing.
We have brought her passion into creating this experience.
Let her be the big vampire lady.
Of course, it also has the combat, resource management, and horror elements you expect from Resident Evil. We've also made sure there's plenty of gameplay content as well.
That's good. It's good that there's gameplay.
We like
the game.
In the previous showcase, we told you that we'd have another demo ready for you across multiple platforms.
Oh.
Well, I'm happy to announce that the next demo experience will be available on PlayStation 5, PlayStation 4, Xbox Series X.
There we go.
Keep going.
What else you got down there? Steam? Okay, there you go. Dan's playing now.
In the game event that we were unable to hold, we have prepared a special day where you can experience
Resident Evil. And that day is?
Here are the details on when need to be available.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
60 minutes? My cup runneth over with blood.
60 minutes to explore both the village and castle areas.
Okay, interesting.
You're free to spend one full hour for both stages. Or choose which one you want
to play. Sorry, chat.
It's a preview where you spend your survival horror experience. PlayStation 5 and PlayStation 4 owners will also get early access as well. We've titled it 8 Hours in Village.
Wait, why would you call it 8 Hours in Village if you can only
play wait an hour? Wait, what?
So this is above me, way above me.
Yeah. In honor of Resident Evil Village being the 8th major installment of the franchise,
I guess I'm confused.
We'll have an 8-hour window to try out the demo for 30 minutes. PlayStation players will have early access to the village section first, followed by the castle section. For the early access players, feel free to also
Jake says, did you guys not already play this demo? No, we have something else. So
we will be able to show off the demo to everyone.
Tell them that.
For the multiple platform demo.
Yeah, if you like exclusive gameplay, you just keep it locked. That's all I gotta say to you.
We'll be able to enjoy the Resident Evil Village demo. Finally, players will be able to pre-order the demo ahead of time. PlayStation 5 and PlayStation 4 owners are able to pre-download the demo starting today.
Wow.
There we go. We love the preload.
Please visit our official website
for more
details.
I guess I need
details.
To see that spelled out, not in video format, to understand like exactly what's happening.
You get a special window if you're the PS. Basically, there's a PS bonus, but everybody gets the demo. Great. Yep.
I'm so torn where to spend my time.
Because PS5 owners only got a chance to play that first demo, right?
Let us know what the plan is. But in the meantime, what if I told you there's another surprise in store? Any guesses?
Oh.
Let's see if we can get director Mori Masasato to tell us.
You know, I bet he's going to tell us more about what he knows.
Find out.
Dude, oh my gosh. I don't know if I can take any more hype, though. I'm kind of getting...
You're getting overhyped? Breathe, Dan. The key is breathing.
Okay. All right, I'm trying.
In and out.
Hi, everyone. I'm director Mori Masasato. I'd like to take this opportunity to tell you about the much-requested extra game mode included in Resident Evil Village. The Mercenaries.
What?
For those of you hearing about it for the first time,
PvE?
It's a beloved extra mode featured in various games in the franchise. It's best known for high-speed,
arcade-style
action, where you have to reach the goal within a certain time limit. Of course, we've also added some new touches to it. So let's dive into some of the additions we've made.
The shop.
Welcome. The first change is that we've added
a shop. I saw this guy in Game Informer.
Yeah, you did. Yes, you did.
Access the Duke's Emporium between areas. You're free to purchase new weapons with the money you collect, or upgrade your arsenal to fit your playstyle.
I saw you eyeing that one. Weapons modifications, and we'll do.
Thank you for your patronage.
Darn. I don't like that guy.
Yeah, he kind of creeps me out a little bit.
Bring back the merchant, you cowards.
What are you buying?
To be just as fast-paced as the previous installments.
Clear.
Okay. Like a little PvE, a little horde mode, a little PvE.
final stage.
You'll have to consider.
I do like playing with other people stage,
and how you'll customize. I know that Ari has these of options to work with, additional modes and experiences, but they don't really do it for me. You know, the core game is where I'm going to be at.
Yeah. Matt Partsa says, can you shoot him? I was curious if you could shoot the Duke as well.
Did you shoot him?
I did not.
Alex, when you play those developer demos, you have to try to break them in every way you can. That's like the rule.
Make him watch him sweat, yeah.
Oh, I love you with that.
Acquire new abilities to employ your own strategies as you fight your way through each stage.
Minigun.
The Mercenaries in Resident Evil Village is a rich gameplay experience full of surprises, with special rewards for those who persevere.
Sniper is killing it.
Yeah. If you're looking for that zombie, should not stand a chance. I doubt that zombie even saw. Mode that's included with the main game.
Correct.
It's a challenging and rewarding bonus mode packed with content, so we hope everyone is looking forward to it. Thank you so much for watching.
And it sounds like this is included in the game, whereas the multiplayer mode is a little separate, right?
I don't know.
If you haven't already heard, Resident Evil has reached an impressive milestone. On March 22nd, the franchise celebrated its 25th anniversary. And like so many of you, I've been a fan since practically day one. Together, we've watched the franchise evolve from a series of survival horror games to a big umbrella
of good movies, pun.
Toys, board games, and more. Resident Evil
like
Universe is just one of the many ways Capcom is celebrating that anniversary.
So one of your modes that you love so much, Dan.
Earlier this month, but don't forget, Resident Evil RE-verse will be available for free to anyone who purchases Resident Evil Village. The franchise has also inspired change and evolution in the video game industry as a whole. Let's hear from some industry powerhouses here to celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Resident Evil franchise.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Let's celebrate. Can I get a piece of cake? Like umbrella-styled cake?
I'd like to congratulate the Red Velvet. Resident Evil team on their 25th anniversary.
Exciting.
25 years.
Look in his background. Does he have anything?
It's been a true pleasure.
Oh, God. No, we're not doing that. That whole, like, looking at the background thing has got to go.
New ways to advance storytelling.
There's a Kojima statue.
Over the last four.
What does it mean?
What does it mean?
And I can't wait to see what Resident Evil.
I know we just made fun of it, but I'm hardcore looking at the background.
Biohazard 25-year. Me too, I like this background.
Yeah. Wait, there's white walls in PT, right? PT 2!
そしてバイオ7ではPSVRでVRの素晴らしい体験を届けていただきました。ありがとうございます。 そして今度のビレッジ本当に楽しみにしています。ますます進化し続けるバイオハザード、これからも応援します。
Hello, I'm Ashley Swadowski. I'm the character art director at Naughty Dog. I wanted to first congratulate.
Chat, what are we feeling so far? You excited about what you're seeing? Are you going to try out the Mercenaries mode? I'm curious.
Amazing Resident Evil titles.
I think chat wanted to see more of the core game.
Or what part of the game.
AKA Lady D.
You've brought inspiration to so many people.
This is a nice little touch here, but.
So thanks so much, guys. And again, congratulations.
Hello.
I think this is a very nice ode right here, bringing in people from the industry to say how much they love it. But it also, in a way, is just, you know, it feels like it might be padding on this event.
Slows the process down a little bit, yeah.
A Resident Evil game. You had me at day one.
They're building towards the one last thing.
Incredible franchise.
I know. One last thing. I am so ready for one last thing.
You know, really enjoying kind of seeing, you know, seeing how your beloved franchise has sort of developed over these last 25 years. It's awesome. So huge congratulations to all of you.
All right.
Infinite darkness.
That's a lot of darkness.
That is quite a bit of darkness.
Producer on live action and anime entertainment for Resident Evil. This year marks the 25th anniversary of the series. Having worked as a programmer on the first title and as producer on several titles over the years, it's amazing to see how far the franchise has come. It's a brand name that you hear even in the movie business, and it's thanks to the love and support from the fans. To all of you, thank you so much. Now, we have something new to show you today from one of our latest projects. Please sit back and enjoy.
I love it. World premiere!
Okay, this is gonna be it. This is gonna be it.
This is the Netflix movie or anime, right? Special.
Would appear that way.
Leon?
Claire?
Could you take a look at something? A little boy drew them. I can't get anyone to go on record. Doesn't that look a lot like Raccoon City?
That little boy's got talent.
Yeah, man.
I gotta go. Don't do anything stupid.
Hey, Leon. That outfit doesn't suit you.
Yeah.
Let's get the president to the bunker. Anything even remotely hostile gets a headshot.
That's a good policy. Huh.
Did you release date? July. Oh,
it's right around the corner.
That's sooner than I thought. I thought that was going
to
be fall.
To share the latest trailer for Resident Evil Infinite Darkness with you today, starring Leon and Claire. It takes place in 2006, approximately 2 years after the events of Resident Evil 4.
I was wondering if they were going to stick to
a zombie outbreak is happening in the White House, and the president is none other than the father of Ashley Graham from Resident Evil 4. He's just one of the many characters that we'll be introducing along the way. So please
Netflix
stay tuned.
Series.
Resident
right?
Evil
you know?
Infinite Darkness
Hit or miss?
Will be airing
miss?
On Netflix Worldwide
like,
in July 2021.
Yeah. I like
and I have one more
Castlevania, the first couple seasons
related
I've watched.
To the live action reboot of
I'll
Resident
tell you that I will never forgive
filming
them for
in
Death
Toronto
Note.
Has wrapped up, and we're in the middle of creating the creatures.
Yo, I almost finished
CGI.
Death Note, by the way.
So
that's not for that conversation
for
here, but.
Including the release date. Until next time, thank you for watching.
If they take Cowboy Bebop from me,
oh,
that will be the end of my relationship with Netflix forever.
You're moving out to like a farm in Ireland and you'll never be seen or heard from again.
I'm going, right to Hulu. I'm going to Hulu and never looking back.
Oh no. Oh, this doesn't look pleasant. Ow.
Ooh.
Dead by Daylight. Did we...
Yeah, probably.
On behalf of everybody here at Behavior, congratulations on 25 years of horror. Over the years, our very own 4v1 multiplayer action game, Dead by Daylight, has become the Hall of Fame of horror. And today, I'm excited to say Resident Evil will soon be joining our universe.
Dead by Daylight fans.
Now tune in to our 5th anniversary broadcast on May the 25th.
We have to tune into something else.
The Resident Evil chapter coming to DVD.
They really got us, don't they?
Mm-hmm. The meantime, yeah, man, it's drip feeding.
It,
you gotta keep going
you get
with
some
them.
Practicing before the chapter comes into the fog.
Ooh, get some practicing. All right, I'm picking it up. How can I play all these games?
Kill or be
Steve,
killed.
Probably right.
It's your call.
You could probably also go to GameInformer.com to find out, right?
Oh,
we talk
I'm
about games
right now.
Right
well,
there.
We're not quite finished yet. Here's one more announcement.
Oh,
one more thing.
To a brand new point of view. Let's take a look.
Okay. A brand new point of view.
One more. World premiere.
Oh.
VR.
Hey,
Hi.
Hold on. We don't
I'm
know
Mike
what it
Morishita,
is.
Executive producer at Facebook. Resident Evil, the franchise that changed the way we think about video games. Is still going strong after 25 years. Congratulations, Capcom, on this incredible milestone. Now let's rewind
it's coming
for a moment.
To VR!
I remember when Resident Evil 4 launched in 2005. It was
It's
amazing.
On everything!
Really,
I think it's on more platforms than Skyrim
like
at this
before.
Point.
And it remains at the pinnacle of the survival horror
They
genre.
Have to be almost neck and neck.
In the 16 years since the launch
Doom?
Of Resident Evil 4,
Doom is on a
the
lot
gaming
of things.
Industry has evolved, and new ways to play have entered the market. And we've been eager to explore how Resident Evil 4 could be enhanced for a modern audience.
How are they going to translate this?
I'm Mike Perdue, VP of Content at Facebook Reality
Life,
Labs.
Life finds a way.
I'm excited to announce that Capcom, Oculus Studios, and Armature Studio are partnering to bring Resident Evil 4 to Quest 2.
In like a year, probably,
We're
Matt.
Thrilled about this game. We can't wait for you to experience the world of Resident Evil in a new medium. It's immersive, comes with a first-person perspective, and will bring new richness.
Blake Hester, if you're watching, does this get you hyped?
Resident Evil 4 experience you know and love. You'll be able to step inside the game for the first time. Tune in to the Oculus Gaming Showcase next week, April 21st, for more details on Resident Evil 4 VR. How we brought this title to this new medium, and you can check out some additional gameplay footage as well.
I think we just met.
You can tune in on the Oculus Facebook
page. Let's do
it. Take a look.
Or on Twitch.
My father?
I still awake.
That's right. You remember? Remember?
Remember, Barris? Alrighty. I think.
Wow.
That's it, probably, right?
This has
been. And that's it for our showcase.
Legendary.
Let's recap the exciting news from today's event. Resident Evil Village releases on May 7th, and a demo experience will be available for a limited time each week leading up to the game's launch. PlayStation owners can pre-download the demo starting today. The Mercenaries mode was also announced.
Definitely
going to
download the demo, but also look up on Game Informer how that it's going to work.
And finally,
I'm going to Game Informer right now because they got the exclusive details on a lot of cool stuff.
Yes, they do.
Click, 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 click. Hey, I'm there. I'm watching videos only on GameInformer.com.
Thanks again for spending some time with us today for another exciting showcase. I'm your host, Brittany Brombacher, and it's been an honor being here with you again and hosting this event. Have a great day.
You as well. Congratulations on the baby. Alrighty.
Bye-bye.
Indeed.
Oh.
Another time.
Oh. Lady D.
Lady D. Alrighty. Well, there we go.
That was a little less gameplay than I wanted to see, with some smaller announcements on the side, which was expected.
Yep.
Back over the years and think.
Yeah. The Resident Evil 4 on VR is an interesting surprise. Not something I don't know if people were wanting that or expecting that, but like, you know, I'm at least moderately curious. You know, I don't need to know too much more about this story because, like, you know, I want to keep that a mystery, but
sure.
I would have liked to see a little bit more uncut gameplay. You know what I mean? Like, you know, a full, not a full level, but, you know, something along those lines.
I would have liked to have seen a couple minutes of level.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe, like one or two. Yeah.
It was just a typical shot to shot. You know, what's going on? I don't know. Oh, there's a monster. Oh, I shot at it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Sweet.
Cool. Yeah.
Yes. I shot it. It's a very technical term.
Yes. Yes, you did. Still don't know what Mother Miranda's doing. We do know now that the Jeff Bridges looking guy and Lady D are related. He said, you know, I believe so. She said you fell for my brother's trap or whatever, and you saw him like start and getting dragged. The sequence where it was her and him, and then like the lichens around and like the Mad Maxian like pit. I was like, okay, this is cool. This is weird. I'm here for it. But I we need to know more, which we'll get in less than a month. So
yeah, there was one big takeaway from that entire video, and that was Ethan Winters.
Guys,
how many times do you think the name got said? I think it was like 9, maybe 10.
Probably. They really want you to know who the main character is. So does that?
It worked. I got it. It has made its way through the membranes of my mind.
Yes, okay. You will not forget it. Consigliere 422 says, do you think your demo progress can transfer to the full game? I'm guessing no.
Probably not.
It seems like how they're segmenting it seems like the feeling I get is like they want to push people to explore as much as they can in that little bit of time. But we'll see what that actually entails, right? Let's see. We also had the Infinite Darkness trailer confirmed July, which I don't think we knew, which, you know, Dan is still reeling from Death Note, but, you know, the animation
looks
great.
I'll never forgive them for that. I will never, ever forgive them for that.
That's fair. That's fair. So intriguing stuff. Could have had a little bit more gameplay, you know, but it was quick. So, I don't know. Tack, any thoughts?
I wanted more, but you know, with a horror game, I like to go in kind of like not knowing what to expect. But at the same time, I really would have liked to have some inkling of what gameplay is. But conversely, we do get a demo, a much longer, you know, more extended look at this stuff. So
yeah,
with only a month away from this demo point or less, like that will be actual like gameplay. It will not be nearly as much of a vertical slice, right? We'll actually get to shoot things.
Yep.
I'm assuming. So
yeah,
it's very interesting to see how that goes. We can make our own decisions. So mm-hmm. we'll make that determination when the time comes.
Yeah. And it's just, it's so weird, this combination of Victorian horror and, like, you know, the special services and Chris and, like, you know, like that combination. It's just, it's bizarre to me. And we're going to find out more soon. But it is interesting. So, chat, what did you guys think? I saw some yays, some nays. I know people are excited to play the demo. Let's see what else we got here. Ebok says, where is Village VR? As far as we know, they haven't said anything about that. I don't know what to tell you. It seems to be MIA, unfortunately. Let's see. What else we got?
Anything else?
TL says, can't wait to play the demo this Saturday. Yeah, I need to go back and look at the dates and see what actually is happening, but I'm excited to give it a try. So MWAX says, more RE-verse. Yeah, they kind of stayed away from that a little bit. They showed that one screen grab of it. But, you know, nothing too crazy. I think this was just, you know, chill, end of the day stream. You know, I wasn't expecting anything like E3 you know, level of you
oh,
know
E3 yeah. for a single game no
exactly
no. but hey you know like I said I would have enjoyed more gameplay, but since we get to play ourselves, I don't care. Demo is always the best.
Yeah.
Let people actually play it and make their own determination. So let's get in there, let's do it. Hype train leaving the station now.
You sound like a cow who's having a bad time.
But well, that's your interpretation. My interpretation and Lady D's interpretation is that it's awesome.
The only opinion that really matters is Lady D's. So, Dan Tack, I think we call that a stream. How about you?
All right, bud.
Sound good?
I hope everybody had fun today. Leave us a comment. We love it when you do.
Yeah, we do. If it's respectful. But that is the goal, right? Real talk, though, we just started an awesome couple of weeks of coverage on the YouTube page and on the site for Resident Evil Village. So if you guys came away from this wanting a little bit more, by God, I think I have some more for you. So keep it locked to youtube.com/GameInformer and GameInformer.com. And for Pete's sake, go check out the magazine if you want like that instant like level of knowledge on this. Ben Reeves put together an awesome cover story, so definitely go check that out. Dan Tack, where can the people find you?
GameInformer.com, obviously.
Obvi.
But also, hey, hit me up on Twitter at Dan Tack. It's real simple. And, you know, I'm also on Twitch, twitch.tv/DanSnacks, DanSnax.
You love it. Are you gonna hit up RE7 on your channel?
Yes.
Ooh, there we go. There it is, folks. You got to tune in for that. Dan Snacks, baby. I am Alex Stadnik. I am Game Informer's largest video editor. You can find me on Twitter at Studnik76, Studnik76, like Soldier76. Thank you so much for joining us. We had a lot of fun today. And, you know, we're going to keep doing watch-alongs. We're going to keep doing Resident Evil stuff. So you hit the bell. Hit the bell. That's all you need to do, and you'll know exactly when we're going live.
I just hit the bell so hard that I think I broke my desk.
Oh, we have to go fix the bell. All right, folks. Thanks as always. Be good to one another. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.